Amazon. Live.
Watching local kids come home from school, now arrested for child porn. I'm Dan Billow with a former Boy Scout leader, now in handcuffs.
Late breaking.
A local mom refuses to return books to the library, saying they're too raunchy for young eyes to see. And the local cop, awash with awards, now accused of having a very dark secret. Western News on CW18 starts right now.
Tonight, shots shatter the silence. A peaceful Seminole County neighborhood rocked when a gunman kills two people on the street and then turns the gun on himself. Good evening. I'm Martha Sagalski. Some residents were on their way to work. Others were just crawling out of bed when the gunfire erupted.
Oh, my God. There's three people dead, ma'am. There's another person. It looks like he shot the driver. He shot himself, and he shot this guy on the sidewalk.
The deadly scene played out this morning in the Lakewood subdivision at the crossings near Lake Mary. Detectives say the gunman was going after his ex-wife. West 2's Kendra Astrike has the late-breaking details live tonight in Seminole County. Kendra.
And Martha, what a tragedy here tonight. Five kids are now without their mother and stepfather, as well as their dad, who's the accused shooter. Investigators say a bitter custody dispute over child support led to a deadly shooting here this morning. You can see right now that deputies are still securing this scene overnight as this murder-suicide investigation continues.
Police, I got gunshots being fired outside the house.
Neighbors frantically call 911 as roving gunfire rattles the Lakewood subdivision at 7:30 Thursday morning.
Two to the right of me and then three behind me.
Sheriff's investigators say 59-year-old John Marshall showed up at his ex-wife's house on Holbrook Circle and fired off several shots right through the glass front door. His ex-wife wasn't home. Neither was their Lake Mary High School daughter, who had already left for class. But her new husband was. Neighbors watched as he took off running for his life.
I just saw my neighbor run down the street, and across the street I saw a guy jump out of his window, chase him with a gun, and I heard three shots fired.
Detectives believe the gunman hopped on his scooter to chase down 59-year-old Orville Dale Burkhart, but he only made it a block. His wife, Dale Marshall Burkhart, had been driving to work, but one of the men may have called her back home. She pulled up, detectives say, to watch her ex-husband shoot and kill her husband. Traumatized neighbors saw it too.
There's a dead guy on the sidewalk in front of my house.
Mrs. Burkhart tried to get away from her enraged ex, but backed up into a tree where detectives found her shot dead in the SUV. Then neighbors watched as Marshall turned the gun on himself.
He's walking out with the gun to his head, and he just shot himself.
And we were not expecting this.
Northland pastor Gus Davies says the Burkharts volunteered at the church and knew there were challenges with her ex-husband, but never imagined the three lives would end with such violence.
That's the other ways. That's never the option.
The couple divorced. Investigators say because Marshall abused the kids. One daughter is in high school, two girls in college, as well as a son and daughter abroad. Now, investigators say their investigation here could take weeks because Marshall's past spans around the world. Live in Seminole County, Kendra Astrike, West 2 News on CW18.
The two separate crime scenes at the double murder-suicide paralyzed the neighborhood. Police say bullets were first fired at the house on Holbrook Circle near Lake Mary High School, and that's when the man inside came out running and rushed down the street. But the shooter caught up to him and killed him at the end of Sundance Drive. That's when the shooter's ex-wife showed up at the second crime scene and was gunned down as well. The public will get a chance to examine Casey Anthony's defense budget, a judge ruling against a motion today that would have sealed any records related to taxpayer money. Casey is using the money to pay for her defense. We didn't find out exactly how much money Casey will receive, but a judge says he'll give more financial leeway because the state is seeking the death penalty. The Boy Scouts motto, be prepared, but no scout or parent could have been ready for this. A former local scout leader is now under arrest, accused of trying to solicit pictures of naked boys on the internet. West 2's Dan Billow has a local bust all new tonight in Brevard County.
Angie Cameron is disgusted.
Is that what you said, a Boy Scout leader?
Her neighbor, Adam Brigham, is a Boy Scout leader and a sex predator, according to investigators, who collects child porn and solicits teen boys for sex.
We came up with a lot of pictures of what appeared to be teenage boys and a number of them that were sexually explicit in nature.
We have lots of kids on this road. That's very disturbing.
Quite a few kids live on this street. Their bus stop's down at the corner, so this is the way they'd walk home from school. And every single day, right here at the fence gate, would be Adam Brigham standing there, watching them.
Yeah, my son would walk home from the bus stop and he'd say, Mom, why is he waiting out there by the road?
Got to be careful these days with your kids, unfortunately.
Detectives say they have no evidence of sexual contact with any of Brigham's scouts. They say he used MySpace.com to contact teen boys and get them to send photos.
They admitted to sending sexually explicit pictures to Mr. Brigham at his direction, the poses that he wanted, those types of things.
He's kind of odd. He was always home. I didn't see him working or anything.
It's kind of interesting to us. You have a single man who doesn't have any kids involved in that particular activity, yet puts himself there.
Detectives believe there are other victims. Brigham faces up to 120 years in federal prison. In Grant, Valkaria, Brevard County, Dan Billow, West 2 News on CW18.
A 12-year-old boy stricken with terminal brain cancer was granted his wish to come to Disney World in Orlando, but it was on that trip when Terrell Travis Jr. would die. An organization called American Dream Flight picked Travis up of his hometown of Milwaukee. They flew him here to Disney, but last Wednesday, Travis Dunn was swimming in the pool at the hotel where he was staying. His cause of death has not yet been released. Local parents on alert tonight after a man tries to grab a young boy on his way home from school. Orlando police say the boy was walking actually to Memorial Middle School this morning when a man tried to grab the student and pull him into an abandoned lot. The boy says the man wanted him to touch his private parts. That child took off running and told his teachers. Seven people injured today in a bus crash in Orange County. A Lynx bus collided with another car at Silver Star Road and Powers Drive. Five people went to the hospital, but all the injuries were minor. The driver of the bus was not cited in the crash. No word on what caused it. New poll numbers show Charlie Crist still may be the man to beat in Florida Senate race. A recent Mason-Dixon poll after Crist announced he would run with no party affiliation shows Crist leading with 38% of those surveyed. Republican Marco Rubio has 32% and Democrat Kendrick Meek has 19%, but 11% of voters are still undecided. Late breaking right now, crews in the Gulf of Mexico are getting ready for the big fix, but there's no guarantee that it will work. BP is prepared to unload a massive dome and lower it over a leaking oil well at the bottom of the Gulf. The project could take several hours. Meantime, Governor Charlie Crist just sent a letter to the president asking for $50 million to protect Florida's coast from the oil slick. Daytona Beach leaders want to make sure everyone knows they are oil-free. Workers with the Visitors and Convention Bureau say they're receiving many calls from concerned beachgoers. So the Bureau is updating its website to show people exactly where they are in relation to that slick.
We're just encouraging people to take a look. You know, if you need a reminder of what our beaches look like, they're phenomenal, and, you know, take a look.
Officials insist they aren't trying to steal business from anyone. They say they are promoting Florida's East Coast in time for a critical summer season. West 2's 10 at 10 checking your weather right now with Chief Meteorologist Tony Manoffi. And the storms have passed, Tony, but the weather is pretty sticky out.
That's an understatement. You're absolutely right about that. It is very humid out there tonight, and we are going to be dealing with more thunder showers tomorrow. Let's break down what's going on out there right now. Still a few stray showers across southern Osceola County and offshore at this hour, but the bigger picture shows what's going on south and east of Orlando. A few showers pulling away, lots of offshore lightning. What an unbelievable show folks out there are seeing. We take a look at the rainfall totals now for Thursday afternoon. Canaveral Groves, I should say, 2.25 inches of rain. Winter Park, just under an inch of rain right here at West 2 Studios. Temps outside still running in the low to the mid-70s. As we wake up tomorrow morning, Martha, upper 60s, low 70s. More storms in the forecast tomorrow afternoon. I'll pinpoint them straight ahead.
We'll see you then, Tony. Thanks. Late breaking right now, an arrest in the torture and murder of an Osceola County family. U.S. Marshals captured Jamal Brown in Memphis today. Detectives say he and four other men shot two people execution style in front of a three-year-old girl in a Point Siena home last October. The four other men are all in custody. Officials think they went to the house to steal drugs. Flames fly on I-4. West 2's high-definition tower cam capturing this car fire on I-4 East, just north of Lee Road tonight. Two lanes of traffic were blocked towards the end of the rush hour. No one was injured. Brazen robbers, guns, and violence rock Orlando's tourist district. Three armed robberies taking place within a half hour of each other early this morning. The first one happened at the McDonald's on John Young Parkway. The men pistol-whipped the manager and took off with cash. Deputies believe the two other robberies are related. A tourist was shot in the parking lot of the Econo Lodge on I-Drive. He is expected to survive. Minutes later, though, a father and and son were robbed walking past the Marriott Courtyard Hotel on Palm Parkway. An Oak Hill police officer involved in a road rage incident has resigned from the force. Officer Brandy Sutherland was on I-95 with his wife and children when a pickup truck rammed his car. He called 911 and gave chase. When the other driver tried to hit him again, he whipped out his personal gun and fired on him. He is not facing any charges. Covering Polk County, go tell it on the mountain. Just don't say it too loud. Lakeland police arrested 49-year-old Anthony Lowry for preaching too loudly at the intersection of Martin Luther King Avenue and Memorial Boulevard today. Officers say they asked him several times to turn the volume down on a sound system, and when he didn't, they cuffed him. Privacy panic on Facebook. Next up at 10, the glitch that opened up intimate conversations to millions. Plus,
always leave things better than the way you found them.
Her words turned upside down why a former cop of the year is getting slapped with federal charges. Miss Kentucky misses a step. Next up at 10, the photo shoot fall that had people turning their heads in Sin City. And naughty novels held hostage why a local mom refused to return Gossip Girl books to a library. This is Western News at 10 on CW18. As an Orlando police officer, she piled up all sorts of awards and accolades. WESH 2 even honored her as a hometown hero back in 2002. But tonight, it's not Amy Brech's resume that's getting attention. It's her rap sheet. The former officer is accused of taking $200,000 in FEMA money intended for Orlando. A city attorney says Brech has set up an account using a city ID number and then allegedly directed hurricane cleanup money into it.
I don't know what was in her head, but she took the money away from us and put it under her control, and that's called stealing.
The city of Orlando found the missing money in 2008 after doing an audit. She retired shortly after that. If convicted, the former officer could face 30 years in federal prison. Another Orlando officer is facing an internal investigation questioning the personal use of a patrol car. We brought you this West 2 exclusive last night. Amateur video appears to show Officer Patricia Brown picking somebody up at Orlando International Airport and tossing luggage inside. While department policy allows officers to drive their cruisers on personal time, they must wear something to identify themselves as officers. The woman's clothing had no police logo. Don't panic. Hundreds of police and firefighters will rush around downtown Orlando tomorrow morning for emergency training. Authorities will hold the exercise at 455 South Orange Avenue. Officials will close Magnolia Boulevard from Anderson to South Streets. It starts at 10 a.m. and runs until 2. The training event comes just months after a gunman opened fire at a downtown office building. Jason Rodriguez was accused of killing one man and injuring five others at the Gateway Center. The New York Stock Exchange with one of the wildest days in its history today. The Dow Jones plummeting nearly 1,000 points in less than a half hour this afternoon. The drop was so enormous that all trading was nearly halted. Under current stock exchange rules, all trading must stop if the market falls 10% or more between 2:30 and 3 p.m. Traders blame the sell-off on debt problems in Greece. There are also rumors a technical glitch contributed to the decline. The Dow eventually recovered and ended the day with a 347-point loss. One of the most feared linebackers in NFL history is now facing a rape charge. 51-year-old Lawrence Taylor is accused of raping a 16-year-old runaway in a suburb of New York City last night. The victim says a pimp brought her to Taylor's hotel room against her will. The former New York Giants linebacker has been arrested several times on drug charges since he retired. NASA calls it a success. Scientists tested a new abort system that can rescue astronauts from an exploding rocket. The new Orion crew capsule was sent up about a mile into the air over the New Mexico desert. The new system would safely pull the astronauts and their spacecraft away from the explosion. It hopes to be a part of the next generation of spaceships currently being designed by private industry. Another flap at Facebook has company leaders apologizing. The social networking website had a glitch yesterday that allowed users to access private information in the accounts of their friends, including chat conversations. The security glitch was open for a few hours before software engineers repaired it. Over the last few months, Facebook has made several changes to its privacy settings, angering millions of users. Lies, cheating, and sex. Gossip Girls is for mature eyes only. The show airs each Monday night right here on CW 18. Millions of young adults love both the show and the books, but at least one local mom thinks the racy page turners should be kept out of the hands of kids. And she even went as far as holding some books hostage to prove her point. West 2's Amanda Ober explains the local protest in Seminole County.
This is not acceptable.
Harden says it's wrong that books from the series that launched the Gossip Girl television show are readily available in the young adult section of Seminole County's library branches.
What disturbed me the most were the references to illegal drug use, sex between a teacher and the student, those kind of things.
Harden's daughter checked out four of the books from the Lake Mary branch over a year ago. When Harden found profane language and references to teens having sex with a Costco-sized box of condoms, she was upset. Harden decided not to return the books to the library, saying she didn't want other kids to read them. She's since been trying to get the library to post a warning label on the books regarding the adult content. The library did make one compromise. It moved the books here to the adult fiction section. Now, some people may argue that even that is censorship, but the library would claim that the books are still readily available to anyone who wants to read them, including kids. No one from the library would comment on camera. As for Harden, she finally returned the books Thursday, saying she'd realized her goal of getting attention for her cause. She did put off paying the $85 overdue fine and says she's also not giving up on her fight for warning labels. In Seminole County, Amanda Ober for West 2 News on CW 18.
More like a midsummer's afternoon here in Central Florida today. We had some strong thunderstorms pounding the region. Tony, is that going to go away in time for the weekend?
For the weekend, yes. For tomorrow, no. I got a lot of emails. Hey, are we in a wet season now? We've had these afternoon showers and thunderstorms. The answer is no. I'm going to show you why here in a second. Look at this great-looking shot. Thunderstorms offshore earlier this afternoon, followed by a pretty sunset. All this over towards Brevard County, in and around the Cocoa Beach area. Great shot there from our crews in Brevard County. From there, I want to go right to WSI. I want to show you the stationary front. This has really been the trigger and the focus point the last couple of days for all of the afternoon showers and thunderstorms. thunderstorms. Even at this hour, we put this into 3D mode off to the south and east now of Melbourne. We have some showers and thunderstorms. Now, what I've done here is I've used Viper radar, and I've basically sliced the Doppler in half for you so that we can see the internals. We're seeing into the storm right now. You can see all the lightning. And watch how that hail, the lightning core and that thunderstorm core is growing vertically. So that's a pretty intense thunderstorm. But again, moving offshore, kind of a 3D perspective of what's going on internally in that thunderstorm. All right, back to the southeastern corridor here off the coast of Brevard County. Look at all that lightning pulling away now. Not going to be an issue for our friends here in southern Brevard County. But tomorrow, it's a new day. That means renewed thunderstorms. And guess where it's going to be? Osceola, Brevard, Orange, and probably as far north as southern and central Volusia counties there. And all of this, just like today, moving off towards the south and the east. Big concerns tomorrow, the damaging winds, the hail, and the very heavy rain, upwards of 1+ inches of rain, especially across Brevard County. Somewhere locally, 2, maybe even 3 inches with those slower moving late afternoon showers and thunderstorms. Highs tomorrow, it's going to be on the warm side, no doubt about that. Upper 80s along our east coast as you work your way westward now through the interior, whether you're spending the day over towards the attractions or up towards the horse country in Ocala. Afternoon high temperatures here running about 90 to 92 degrees. Keep in mind now, the average high should be running right around 87, not 92. All right, so changes coming. We're not in our wet season because we're still getting fronts coming on through. Just in time for Mother's Day, you gotta like this. A northeast wind flow, lower humidity, daybreak temperatures running in the upper 60s. A nice breeze, but emphasizing now, less humidity as we get into Mother's Day afternoon. High temperatures running in the mid-80s. Sun sets now at about 8:05 in the extended 7-day outlook. Looking pretty good for next week. Afternoon high temperatures Monday and Tuesday, mid to upper 80s. Martha, by Wednesday and Thursday, we're back to around 90. And overnight low temperatures again in the upper 60s.
Tony, thank you. A pageant princess takes a tumble. Miss Kentucky took a spill during a Miss USA photo shoot in Las Vegas yesterday. She apparently lost her footing while having a group photo taken. Down she goes. Luckily for her, other contestants broke her fall and helped her back up on her feet. The Miss USA pageant will be broadcast live Sunday, May 16th.